Welcome, dear ladies and gentlemen. We would like to say hello to our daily global webinar. We call it Real-Time Daily Trading Ideas, 5 days. Five traders, we would like to screen the market, show you some interesting trading setups, and answering your questions. But first of all, here are our risk disclaimer. Be aware that Forex and CFDs are leveraged products and can result in losses that exceed your deposit. So they may be not be subtitled for everyone. Please be aware that all we are showing and presenting here is just a personal opinion and not an advice for investing. So as I said at the beginning, 5 days, five traders. Today is with Nenad. So later more about Nenad and his trading style. So here a short overview of our offers. So for example, maybe our best seller, the DAX 30, we offer it for a typical fixed spread of only 0.8 points during the main trading hours. So if you have additional question for our products or services, so feel free to contact us. Here you can see our contacts with our telephone number and also email. So all these webinars are recorded, so you can find it later in our YouTube channel. So I say hello to you, Nenad. Hope the sound is well and you can hear me.
Hello again, and excellent to hear you. So the sound is great. We will have some nice trading opportunities today. And let's see. So first, I want to show you a potential trade on GBPN. So GBPN basically is going up, and this could be an uptrend in progress on even on higher time frames. So if we take a look at 4 hour time frame, we will do it right now. So 4 hour time frame is strongly to the upside. This big candle is also going up. So this pin bar reflects buyers. Also, daily time frame is strongly to the upside. It looks like the pound yen is actually targeting 156.33 with a potential to extend to 156.63. So there could be some trading opportunities within this range, 155.60, 155.70. So this could be a time for potential long trade. Stop should be placed at 35. So let's say that if we make a trade now, definitely stop loss should be placed around 155, potentially 155.32, I would say, because if the price gets below that, it could be a breakout to the downside. For swing traders, guys, stop loss needs to be placed below 155. So it depends. So if you're an intraday trader, 155 0.32. If you're a swing trader, 155 0.00. So definitely it depends also on your account, how much you're willing to risk, how much you want to actually allow this potential trade to breathe. As I say, for intraday setups, if this level breaks 32, I think it can go down. It can actually it can be stuck within this range, then 155.05, 155.32, 33. If it stays above this level, okay, this zone that is defined clearly by daily L1 and daily H1, there is a potential to go towards 156.35. So definitely there are some opportunities on pound yen, but you really need to assess it from a different type of trading. Is it a swing trade or is it a intraday trade? It really depends. Now, regarding other potential pair that I would like to stress out, of course, it is the dollar CAD. If you remember my analysis from yesterday, I will show you right away the analysis that I did, of course, on Admiral Markets. Just give me a few seconds. And if you go to the main page, analytics, technical analysis, here, dollar cat is below the Chuvashov's fork. This was my analysis, and if you traded this analysis, if you traded it from this spot where I said it could reject, you would have made some nice pips short term. Call it a scalp, call it a scalp swing. But if you short it exactly here where I said in the text, well, then you would have made nice pips. Nice comments. Vincenzo is saying the King Nena. Thank you, King Vincenzo. Thank you. Thanks a lot for comment. Wolfgang is saying everything is fine. Thank you. Yes, I mean, everything is fine, definitely. And I will show you today possible another short, guys. You see how dollar cat is going down. Now, the price is indeed below the weekly L5. And now what I can say is, again, if it gets towards this spot here, 2350, I think this could be another short. Just pay attention, guys. You see, if the price gets here, okay, it could reject up all the way down to this double bottom. But if it rejects there and it doesn't have a momentum to proceed further down, you need to pay attention, because this could be then inverted head and shoulders. And inverted head and shoulders, guys, if it happens, then it could be a sign for dollar cat actually to retrace, guys. So you really need to be very careful regarding those longs if this level holds. So please pay attention to it. Do not think that everything is clear if the price does not break on rejection this level again. So ideally, it would be good that shorts are already in place. So you have a trend line here, you see. And if they are, the price will continue down towards this spot, ATR 14 projection low. But if it doesn't happen, we might see a break of this trend line, a pullback towards this zone. So pay attention. It will be either break it or make it. So either a drop or a bounce above this trend line. If it happens, then pay attention to this level. If you see a confluence, there is a potential that the price might actually, let's say, reject from this level. You need to pay attention to daily L3 again. Because if it does, if the price does exactly as I show you, that could be inverted head and shoulders, and it will be it will be a possible reversal. So at this point, this is bearish. There could be continuation, okay, but you really need to watch for continuation clearly below the level, clearly below this trend line down. And this is the place where I think price could go up. And if you want to go long, also you can watch 2265, 2260, 70. So this could be like nice zone that you could actually place long trades, okay? Now it's short, here is short. If it breaks here, it will be a breakout long towards this spot here in between. And if it continues down, this will be continuation of short trades. So still, dollar is bearish, but please pay attention to either continuation, new position, breakout above, and counter trend trade here. So you see a lot of opportunities you have here. Oh, sorry, guys, you don't see the screen. It is frozen. Okay. Should be okay now. So again, I will repeat, no problems, guys. So there are multiple opportunities. First is continuation of a short trade. It needs to break this trend line, close below it, and go down. Then, if it doesn't happen, watch for a possible trend line break towards this spot. Then, positional short possible here from this spot. If it happens, watch for breakout of this level, daily L3. If it doesn't happen, that is inverted head and shoulders. If it continues down, counter trend positional trade around 2265, 70. Okay, now it should be clear. You're also seeing the screen. So you see, it's very, very obvious. Now I see a question. What is Chuvashov's fork? Well, guys, in order to explain Chuvashov's fork, I think I have some time to actually explain it. The thing is that a lot of I always repeat it. A lot of Western traders, unfortunately, don't know about good Russian traders, because in Russia there are a lot of good traders who simply, you know, because of language difference, they don't do a lot of things in English. But one of them is Stanislav Chuvashov, and he's a Russian trader, and basically he invented something that is called Chuvashov's fork, and it's based on Tom DeMarc trend line principles. Unfortunately, I don't have a lot of time to go into details now, but I can make a special webinar regarding Chuvashov fork. It is, let's say, a two trend line pattern used for trading breakouts and usually counter trend trades. It's very good. I'm currently in the process of making my own indicator for that, but well, it takes some time. So, but I definitely it is in my list. I will show you how it looks like, the original indicator. But as I say, I'm now recoding this indicator, and I will do it for MT4 and of course MT5. So here it is, guys. This is an example of Chuvashov's fork. You need to use fractals here, and basically when you see bearish, the fractals need to be below the lowest price. Then you create a trend line to join two fractals, and then you create a second line that is called a side line that joins the second and third lowest price where the fractals have formed. And when this trend line breaks, it is a signal for a short trade. So this is simply a simple explanation of Chuvashov's fork. As I say, I will go a little bit deeper into details. I will make a special webinar with Admiral, and I will explain what Chuvashov fork is and how you can actually trade it. It's a good thing, guys. Believe me, it's a good thing. I already tested it, and I like it. Indeed, I really like it. Now, yeah, a lot of questions. Rudolf, GBP CAD, GBP Swissy, can we go short? Let's see what it says here. GBP, GBP CAD and GBP Swissy. I will do GBP CAD. Okay, let's see. GBP CAD. Ah, Chuvashov's fork. You see, guys, how Chuvashov's fork work. As I say, I'm currently in a process of making this indicator. I have the source code. I need to recode a few things, not myself, but I have a coder who will do that for me, but I will give him parameters to follow. So you see, this is bullish fork, this is bearish fork, and well, it's very clear. You see how this signal here was, wow, it worked like a charm. So let's see now, GBP CAD, definitely GBP CAD is in uptrend. So let's review it. Daily up 4 hour, up retracement 1 hour. I think GBP pairs are in buy the dip mode. So here you see this was a signal here to go short. Now if this trend line here breaks, this could go down. Even for scalping, guys, this could be good. Let me just remove this. So even for scalping, you see, it needs now to break this trend line here in order to proceed further up. If it doesn't happen, then you need to watch for this zone here. When if it comes to this zone, 74 and 90 to 75, it could reject to the upside. If you want to see a continuation of GBP CAD, it could go up, but it could also go short, Rudolf, because you saw Chuvashov fork showed a short trade. So this could be actually a short, and watch for continuation down if this trend line breaks also. I don't want to confuse you with Chuvashov's fork, and now I need to do webinar before I actually show you how to trade it, when to trade it, and yeah, but according to Chuvashov's fork also it could go down. So watch for a break and possible long here. I think it could retrace. It isn't that strong as GBPN or GBP dollar, so it's a little bit weaker now, but it still has potential to reject. same for all guys, same for all GBP pairs. There could be a retracement, but also they seems that GBP now is really bought on dips. But it could change tomorrow. Tomorrow is Friday, guys, and Friday is day to take profits. So yes, it could change tomorrow indeed. Yeah, should. So be careful, guys. Tomorrow we could see some counter trade moves. Let's see Euro GBP. Euro GBP. I won't be touching Euro, guys. I won't be touching Euro until I actually see the ECB today. So only after the ECB we could see what will happen with Euro. So my trading idea also, guys, is to wait for Euro pairs. Do not trade Euro until the ECB is over. ECB 13:45 my time, so it's 12:45 GMT, okay? And do not go into Euro trades until you see what's going on during ECB conference. Monetary policy guidance, cues for investors, it will be volatile. Use volatility protection setting tool on your Admiral Markets account. Go to Traders Room, activate it if you trade Euro, and wait for the price to settle down before you make any positions. Okay, what I say, sometimes not having a position in the market equals to have to having actually a profitable position. So you also need to know that not having a position sometimes means to be in profit, and that is the case with Euro. I'm not touching Euro now. Carolyn, hey there, T, what happened to your 89 EMA? Carolyn, this is Camarilla MACD trading template. Camarilla MACD analysis template has an 89 EMA. So there are two templates, trading Camarilla MACD and analysis Camarilla MACD. This is trading Camarilla MACD because this is live trading webinar. We are not doing the analysis now, but I have the zone here that can actually resemble the 89 EMA because this is comprised of two special EMAs also. Ahmed is asking, hi Nena, do you see a counter trend trade on New Zealand dollar CAD? Let's see New Zealand dollar CAD. Yeah, there could be a counter trend trade indeed. Watch this. 1, 2, 3, okay? Let's go with extension. Standard 1, 2, 3 pattern. I think this could be a counter trend trade indeed. If this level holds, this is standard 1, 2, 3, a bullish N, because it is in the shape of Latinic N, and it could go up. Okay, first level potential 91.06, then 91.18. It has a confluence with daily L4 all the way up to key level, that is but I don't think it will retrace almost 100%. So this is indeed a potential counter trend and pattern, but watch for daily H3 and breakout above. Okay, this could be indeed, Ahmed. Andre, what about expectation? ECB wants to push Euro lower, of course. Mr. Draghi always wants to push Euro lower. It's in the interest of Germany, of course, to have a lower Euro because they are the major exporters in European Union. So fall expected after the press conference, but market is bullish, so it should go up again after. Indeed, Andre, I agree with you regarding a possible move on euro dollar. What can happen is Mr. Draghi will probably talk down the euro, okay? And then what can happen, because it's bullish sentiment, investors will not listen to that and they will buy it. So I also say, guys, euro dollar is buy on dips. I think the road to 25.00 is open. Today, if euro drops, I expect to be bought later. But you really need to be careful, because if there is some strong bearish sentiment that Mr. Draghi might present with euro, then you really need to be careful where to buy it. Could even drop, I mean, it could even drop here to 23.40, even lower, and then suddenly it can be bought. You need to watch Fibonacci. This is the latest swing from this spot to this spot. So even if it drops here, guys, it will still be bullish, but I don't think that it will drop there. It would be overextension to the downside. That is not good for bulls. So if it drops there, here in this region, you could possibly buy it. Of course, meaning that, Andrei, your expectations are correct, because I also share your opinion, because Mr. Draghi is a master of talking down the euro. But, you know, he cannot trade the euro himself, because he can just move the euro by saying things regarding monetary policy, and investors are those, big traders are those, big money, big fish who move the market. So if they exit the position, it will be used for buying lower. That is my opinion. And yes, I agree. Carolyn, what happens to dollar? When will it go up again? I assume that you are referring to, well, dollar yen. Which kind of, I don't have the dollar index right now, but if you, definitely if you see the sentiment on a dollar, it's not that good regarding dollar yen, especially these guys. There is a big drop and it could go even lower. Again, you need to have a trend line here in place, and you really need to have a strong bearish close below this trend line in order for and without wicks in order to dollar to proceed further down. Now it looks like there could be some retracement, but then again, react on dollar yen after the ECB conference, because euro dollar and dollar yen, they move in counter trend motion. So you know, they are negatively correlated. So if euro dollar goes up, dollar yen is going down. So only if Mr. Draghi talks down the euro, then this could be a potential interim relief for dollar yen. But I expect to be sold again, definitely. Well, the dollar by itself, we will see. When we see a reversal on some, let's say on dollar index, if we see a major reversal happening, then we could talk about overall dollar reversal. But I really need to see daily time frame, weekly time frame, possible divergence, and a trend line break in order to tell you. But I don't have the time now, guys. We are already over the time. I'm trying to be fast with questions. Okay. Valentin is asking, what is the indicator with daily L1, daily L, and daily H1? This is my indicator. It's called Camarilla Pro indicator, and it has, these are all my own custom indicators, and this is the Camarilla that incorporates all important levels, and daily H1, daily L1 are important breakout spots. Okay, I already did a blog on Admiral Markets website. You can see it. It's called Camarilla in 2018 on the Google page. It's first, just type Camarilla Admiral whatever, and you will see Camarilla template explained analysis in 2018, and I am explaining a bit about Camarilla levels here. So you just need to know that for me this is the best pivot point indicator, of course, because that is my own method, my own way of trading the price. Camarilla MACD, that is the source, the constant source of the analysis and trading setups that I give you. Okay, guys, I think that we answered major of questions. A majority of questions have been answered. I hope that you enjoyed the webinar. As I say, unfortunately, I don't have more time. I would like to have more time, but this is fast trading. Potential trading setups. So pound yen buying the dip or intraday, it needs to stay above 32. Swing traders above 0.0. Euro dollar buying the dip, okay, and definitely until we see a reversal on dollar index, we cannot talk about dollar strength. Gintaras asking, could we get Camarilla? There is a free version of Camarilla pivot, of course. You just need to email me, Gintaras. I will send you the pivot indicator for free version of Camarilla. There is a free version indeed. So just send me an email. Thank you, guys. Thank you for listening. As always, I wish you a great trading week, a great trading day, and a lot of success. Cheers, guys. Trade safe.
Okay, Nina, thanks a lot for your screening the markets here today and answering a lot of questions from the audience. So thanks to you, dear listeners. It was a pleasure today. We will see us tomorrow, if you like, with Dirk on Friday. So stay fine and take care. We will see us. Bye-bye.